here we are at U-Haul, 7 a.m, getting ready to take off. And there I go, moving the camera around like an idiot.
Why did you get me up so early?
Why did I pick you up so early?
Why did you wake me up so early?
That's my brother. You want to be on camera?
4 a.m.
You're on the wrong side. Come over here.
4 a.m.
No, over here.
You woke me up at 4 a.m.
Yes. I was nervous and excited. Okay, so we have to wait till U-Haul opens up, but more to come. So as you can see, the door's open behind me, and their packers are up there right now packing. And we should be ready to go in about 4 or 5 hours. And then see where I'm going to end up. So this is the way to pack. We're having almond cookies and coffee. See? Almond cookies from Chinatown. Yes. What's in my bag? Almond cookies. There you see. And right in the back says made in Chinatown. Mary came to say goodbye. So goodbye, Mary.
Goodbye.
It's been fun, and we'll see you really soon. I'll see you soon, sweetie.
Yes.
And then at the next corner, turn left. Goodbye, Hayes Valley. There we go.
That's right.
Turn right. The mock main stage will be in Anaheim, California on October 28th as part of the Now Hear This podcast festival running through October 30th. The festival is a weekend of live podcast events with shows like Criminal, WTF with Mark Maron.
Thing about food, which is our subject tonight, food, is that food so ugly. He and my grandmother had one fight, the way my uncle and my aunt did throughout their lives, and that was about the language of food, because my grandfather came late to this country and my grandmother earlier, and she would never explain to him what important food expressions actually meant when he was 88 and I was visiting him in Florida. He took me aside and said, there's something no one will explain. And I did this terrible, terrible thing that happens.
What that means. And critics, a lot of dignitaries before. We want the critic or whoever that we're trying to impress. It's over 100 years old, and it means the world to chefs. I grew up under chefs where the Michelin guide and the star system meant everything. I would go into work. And Momofuku Co., we serve just about it. There's no real ethnic boundaries to what we serve. We just want to serve something that's delicious. But regardless of whatever we serve at Momofuku, we're grounded in French tradition. And I would say almost all of Western cuisine is grounded in French tradition. And if that's the case, every time we cook something, and every time, Chef Keller, Thomas Keller from the French Laundry said it best, when you make a hollandaise sauce, and you're over the stove, and you're making your liaison, and you make it right, you're going back in time, you're making the same sauce that all these French cooks have made. All these cooks have done the same thing, and you share this moment if you do it right. It's a beautiful thing. I didn't understand it till very recently. So the Michelin guide meant everything. We didn't expect to ever get to a Michelin star and go on and be great on a 3-star system. We're trying to focus on the food, not talk to the guest. And it's not because we're mean mint and covered in some crispy chicken skin. And there's obviously this chicken snail forest.
Is it beautiful?
And I just felt embarrassed giving him this dish. I don't even know if he even liked it. entire time he's eating in, there's this course between myself and Jean-Luc Nouret is happening, he's barely eating his food. They're not large portions, but he's eating a bite or two bites. And you have to know that this is an open kitchen. If it was a closed kitchen, it would have been so much easier, but
it's by the dishwasher and it's full of food. It is the most disheartening thing, and you know somebody messed up. And ultimately, you have to put the blame on yourself.
And I couldn't get a read on this guy. And he's...
Thank you very much.
Day one on the epic journey to my new mystery spot. Cheers.
Así en el cielo se hallará extraviada buscando abrigo y no lo encontrará. También yo estoy en la región perdido.
Oh cielo santo y sin poder.
Perdido.